This question sounded so easy, but it really threw me for a loop. Today, Chris wrote in about a video from 3 years ago called Wildcards in Excel, VLOOKUP, or SUMIFS, and said, is there a way to do this backward? You're looking in column E for anything that contains the word apple, and then looking back into column A to get something from column B. It would probably be easier if I showed it to you. So you have a bunch of text here, and over here, if anything contains apple, then it's red. If anything contains cherry, then it's maroon. You need to search the word gala apple in here and find a match for apple. And I have to tell you, I tried all kinds of things that I thought were going to work, but wouldn't work at all. Like the XLOOKUP, I tried to put wildcards around the lookup vector. That didn't work. I tried to filter wildcards. I tried to use COUNTIFs because it seemed like SUMIFS, and SUMIFS works with wildcards. And none of these worked. Here, unfortunately, this is the best that I have. And down in the YouTube description, I'm sure that people will come up with something far easier than this. I just worked myself into a corner, right? So we're going to use the search function. The search function. What are we going to search for? We're going to search for all of these words from A2 to A8. And we're going to look for them within the word gala apple, right? And what that does is it tells us that apple is found in the sixth position. The second one, cherry, is not found at all. Nut is not found. Ice is not found, and so on, right? So we get this array of either an integer telling where it is in the search word or the value error, all right? The value errors were causing problems down the road, so I just wrapped that in the if error, and then this little thing here converts those zeros into quote quote, so they'll appear to the text join function as empty cells. Finally, text joining with commas in between, skipping the quote quotes, anything that came back from M3 here, right? So putting that all together into a single formula on the inside, the search, the if error, the if, and then finally the text join, it works amazingly well, right? Without really using anything new. You know, the search has been around forever. I guess text join, February of 2017, is the newest, right? So old school formula here. So it's looking through all of these, and apple is the only match, so I'm getting red. It also works for apple and pineapple. Let's see, cherry is coming up as a maroon for cherry, Cherry Jones, Bing Cherry, but not Sherry O'Terry because it's spelled wrong. I had to add O'Terry as an extra item in the lookup table. Peanut, donut, and nut roll all managed to come back as brown because of nut. And then iceberg is white. All right, banana split though. Banana split is interesting because it has two matches. So it's found in both banana and split. And in that case, it returns both categories with a comma in between. When the question came in, I'm like, well, yeah, absolutely, you can do that. I even think I replied with some formula that, of course, later I learned did not work. This is the best I can come up with. And even in this formula, I'm pretty sure that it is overly complicated just because I boxed myself into a corner and so many other things didn't work. You start to become desperate for something that would work. So Chris, that's my answer. Make sure to read the YouTube comments down below, where people much smarter than me will come up with much better ways to do this. I want to thank Chris for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.